I'm Dheeraj Thatar, Assistant Professor in the Chemical Engineering Department of LGIT Ahmedabad. In this lecture, I'm going to start new topic of the Mass Transfer Operation 1. So let's start. Chapter name is Leaching and topic is Equilibrium Diagram in Leaching. So what we have seen in the last lecture, I told you related to the basic concepts of the leaching. So leaching means if you want to extract some constituents from the solid by using liquid, that process is known as the leaching, where we are getting two streams. First one is the overflow stream and second one is the underflow stream. And overflow stream means we are getting the concentration of the solute in the X phase, or I can say that X is nothing but weight fraction of the solute in the overflow stream, and Y is nothing but weight fraction of the solute in the underflow stream. So this is the meaning of overflow stream and underflow stream. Now in this lecture we are going to see equilibrium diagram of the leaching. So here I will consider three component system. First component is your pure solvent, that is component A. Pure solvent means initial amount of the solute in this solvent is equal to zero, means weight fraction of the solute initially present in the solvent is equal to zero. After that, insoluble solid or inert solid, that is nothing but B. And lastly, the solid particle which we want to remove from the solid, that is given by the component C. Now you can see here, this is the graphical representation of the equilibrium diagram in leaching. In case of the leaching operation, you can see on the screen, equilibrium data are plotted on a rectangular coordinate where we are going to plot N versus X and Y. So N is nothing but this is the amount of the insoluble per kg of the solution, and X and Y, this is nothing but weight fraction of the solute which we want to remove in the overflow and underflow respectively. After that, you can see I told you N is nothing but kg of the insoluble per kg of the solution, and X and Y, this is nothing but weight fraction of the solute which we want to remove from the solid, okay, on B free basis in overflow and underflow respectively. B free basis means in denominator we are not going to consider B, that is nothing but insoluble. Means whenever we are writing here mole fraction in the leaching, listen carefully, whenever we are writing mole fractions in the leaching, that X and Y, we are always writing on the free basis, or I can say insoluble free basis. Means you have to write here X and Y on the insoluble free basis. Here B is nothing but your insoluble solid. That's why I am writing X and Y on the B free basis. You can see this is the equilibrium diagram in leaching. So you can just observe here, we are plotting here N versus X and Y. So N is nothing but amount of the insoluble per kg of the solution, and X and Y, this is nothing but weight fraction of the solid particle in overflow and underflow. After that, you can see there JKL. JKL, this is your underflow curve. Okay, and MNP, this is your overflow curve. Means N versus Y. Y is nothing but your weight fraction of the solute in underflow. That's why that curve is nothing but your underflow curve. After that, in below, you can see there in overflow curve, there is N versus X. And X is nothing but weight fraction of the solute in overflow. I told you in leaching we are getting two streams. First one is the overflow and second one is the underflow. Okay, and whatever the required component which you want to remove from the solid, that is present in the overflow. So your required flow is your overflow, and that is given by the MNP. Now we will see some important points related to this curve. You can see here. So you can see here the solute C, which you want to remove from the solid, that is the infinitely soluble in solvent A. That's why the composition of the solute is spread over the entire range of the mole fraction, that is nothing but 0 to 1. After that, you can see the curve JKL represents the separated solid, that is nothing but underflow or wet solid as expected in real practice. Or I can say the JKL, I told you this JKL and MNP gives you the amount of the insoluble, because you can see at the J point there is the some amount of the Y present and N present. Similarly at K point also there is the some amount of the N and Y present, and similarly at point L there also some amount of the N and Y present. So this curve gives you the amount of the insoluble present in the solution. So that is given by the JKL curve. Now you can see here, the curve JKL is the locus of the underflow condition. I told you JKL is your underflow curve and MNP, this is your overflow curve. Now we will see MNP curve. So I told you the curve MNP represents the clear solution. I told you in last lecture as well, clear solution is nothing but your overflow stream. And in this stream we are getting the solute which you want to remove from the solid by using liquid. That is nothing but your clear solution, that stream is nothing but overflow stream. So the curve MNP represents the clear solution withdrawn as the overflow, and thus it is the locus of the overflow composition. Okay, that is nothing but X composition, or I can say wet fraction of the solute in the overflow. And after that, here the curve MNP lies above the n is equal to 0 axis, that is nothing but X axis, which indicates that the overflow contains some amount of the insoluble solid B. And lastly, you can see in this case the presence of the insoluble solid in the overflow indicates that the insoluble solid is slightly soluble in the solvent. In this case, the presence of the insoluble solid in the overflow indicates an insoluble solid is slightly soluble in the overflow stream, or I can say that is slightly soluble in the extracting solvent. Okay, that is not our requirement, means pure solvent is such a solvent in which insoluble is not soluble. But here you can see MNP lies above the x-axis, means that overflow stream contains some amount of the insoluble as well. Now you can see here, the tie line, that is a KN line, is not vertical line. Okay, so that is not vertical. When this happens, you can see there are two conditions when this can be happen, means this KN line cannot be vertical. First point is, if you are not providing enough time for the extraction of the solute from the solid by using liquids, means if you are not giving the enough contact time for the solid and liquids for the leaching process, then this can be possible. And secondly, second point is, if your insoluble part, whatever the insoluble solid is present, that is soluble in your solvent, that is soluble in your extracting solvent, in your pure solvent, then and then this can be possible, means this tie line cannot be vertical. Okay, so I am repeating, KN is not vertical here because you are not providing the sufficient contact time for the solid and that extracting solvent for the leaching process. And secondly, that insoluble solid is soluble in your extracting solvent. Okay, so that's why this KN line is not vertical. Now we will see another curve. So you can see here, KN line, or I can say the vertical line, that is NM. Okay, there are two vertical lines are present, that is nothing but tie lines. All those vertical lines are the tie lines, and here that those are the vertical lines, means here I can say we are providing the sufficient contact time for the solid and liquid for the leaching process. After that, you can see there is the JNK. Okay, this line is the straight line, means there is the constant underflow is there, that line is the straight line, but in previous figure that is not straight line. Okay, so there was, that is the varying line. So that's why I can say the JKL in previous slide, that is the variable underflow, but here this JNK line is the constant line, straight line. So I can say that this underflow condition is the constant in nature. Okay, so you can see here, after that there is the MNP. We have seen in previous slide that MNP lies above the x-axis, means overflow stream contains some amount of the insoluble, but here that MNP line is coincided with the x-axis. So I can say here the insoluble is not present in your overflow stream, means you are using here pure solvent. So this is our requirement, where we don't want any insoluble part in our overflow stream. So you can see here, the overflow contains no insoluble solid B, either dissolved or suspended, so that the locus of the overflow composition is represented by the x-axis. And finally, the line JK representing the locus of the underflow composition is horizontal, which indicates that the amount of the solution retained by the insoluble part, okay, that is the constant in nature. I told you, if that JNK line is, or I can say JK line is the straight line, at that time there is the constant underflow. If that line is the varying, then I can say the varying underflow is present. I am repeating here, two lines, vertical line represents the tie line. It means we are providing the sufficient time for the leaching process between the solid and liquid. And after that, JK, this line is the straight line, means there is the constant underflow. I will explain you related to the constant underflow and varying underflow in next slide as well. So before that, just see a first one. I told you that tie lines here are the vertical because we are providing here sufficient time for the leaching process between the solid and liquid. And after, here insoluble part means insoluble solid is not soluble in your extracting solvent. Okay, means we are getting here tie line as the straight line, vertical line, because we are providing sufficient contact time for the leaching process. Now we will see constant and variable underflow. Constant underflow means whatever the line, that is the underflow line, we have seen in previous slide as well, that is the JK line, that is the straight line, that means that is the constant underflow. Before that we have seen that is the JKL line, that is the varying underflow. Okay, so that is the variable underflow, and in previous slide that is the JK line, that is the straight line, means that is the constant overflow. So what is the meaning of this constant and variable underflow? You can see here now. First point is the amount of the solution retained by the solid, that is nothing but insoluble solid, in the underflow determines the locus of the underflow composition. Okay, and if the underflow composition is the constant, means whatever the solution retained by the insoluble solid, if that is the constant in nature, then I will get the constant underflow. But whatever the solution that is the retained by the insoluble solid, that if that is the variable, okay, at that time I will get variable underflow. So you can see here, so here we are having two underflows. First one is the constant underflow and variable underflow. I told you what is the meaning of variable underflow. You can just see here now, when the amount of the solution, or I can say when the amount of the solvent is retained by the insoluble solid in the underflow varies and the function of the solid concentration, then we have the variable underflow. Okay, the condition are known as the variable underflow. It means whatever the solution retained by the insoluble solid, if that solution, if that solvent, or I can say extracting solvent, is available in insoluble solid in variable condition, or varying underflow, or I can say variable underflow. And if that the solution retained by the insoluble solid is constant in nature, that is nothing but your constant underflow. So this is the definition for constant underflow. You can see here, when the amount of the solution is retained by the insoluble solid in the underflow is constant and independent of the solute concentration, then we are having constant underflow. Okay, so we are having here underflow stream and overflow stream. These are the two types of the underflow. First one is the variable underflow and constant underflow. I am repeating, variable underflow means whatever the solution retained by the insoluble solid, if that varies, then I can say the underflow is nothing but your variable underflow. And if the solution is retained by the insoluble solid, that is a constant in nature, that is not varying, then I can say the underflow stream is your constant underflow. Okay, so this is all about this lecture. We will see next topic in the next lecture. Thank you very much.